Wow, that was great. Thank you, Mike, so much. That was incredible. How's the beer?
Good.
You good? Yeah, it's local brewery, East End Brewery. It's good stuff. Be sure and donate for the beer if you. Our next person, something I should mention now, the third person on your program tonight, Paradise Gray, is not going to be able to be here this evening. He had a death in the family and couldn't make it. So we're going to shuffle our program around just a little bit, and we'll have, we'll shuffle the program a little bit. It'll be great. So is Lanny here? I actually didn't see him. Lanny, are you okay? Great.
I'm nervous, but here.
Okay. Well, our next presenter is. Do I have your stuff here, Lanny? Well, Lanny, I don't have your intro written down, but here's what I know, and then maybe we can fill in the rest. Lanny is a poet and a musician, an artist. Emerged from Occupy Pittsburgh and the camp, just tell me if I'm getting any of this wrong, with a newfound zeal to express the issues surrounding the Occupy movement. And so Lanny is going to read some poetry tonight, and let's give a big hand for Lanny.
Is too big for me to use. Okay. So, hi. I can hear myself on that, and it's really awkward. Okay. I'm going to read you things, and usually I play music, and I'm a lot better at that, but I decided I was asked to read things, and I have a lot of things that I haven't made into song that I want to, so I'm going to read you four things, and two of them go together, and those are the first two. But just bear with me because I'm like super, super anxious. Okay. Thanks. So the first thing I'm going to read is called The Epic of Everything All at Once, or The Acceptance of the Aw Sound. For a background on this, it is about a sacred place called Whiskey Run. You'll hear the name mentioned. And yeah, so I'll just say it at that because it really explains itself. Oh. The following was written within a breach of space and time. I was bred from the movement of love and sound. In silence I find this, and I know I have not come here to forget, but I have come here to ask for guidance in my attempt to accept that just because mother dwindles in delusional denial does not mean that music has to stop. On the contrary, I must make sure the sound never ceases, for I know it never does. Even if it is seemingly silent, though we so often forget this, but there is so much more to be done. The baptism of solitude, independent decisiveness to face past and respectively allow myself to experience fear, vulnerability, love, all ultimately resulting in strength. For all the flowers, there are also flames. Look up all around to the darkness, for it is the ultimate epitome of embrace. And she so vast a name gave clarity and subtle sound that to truly understand one must look down, for everything moves on the ground, alive in its dying, the changing of the seasons being the only thing worth relying on. And clarity in the form of calm rationalization, or shall I say realization, now. Go. Sit on the gas well. Face a fear. This time it'll be lonely, but impulses followed intuitively will be rewarding. And from here I can smell the fumes of fear. On a metallic cylindrical mountain, smell it. Small steps, one small win. But a win signifies an end, and this is no end. This is a novel of never-ending chapters. This is a landscape of ever-shifting dream expanses. This is... The butterflies are still following me. Whiskey Run. But I want to say some sort of maternal eternity. Thank you, for now I shall descend. And near the gods of the gas wells, there was timber rattling black snakes and yellow spiders marking paths. Like fear's crossroads, come in many bodies to make sure you set towards to finding your own. And I took only pictures, but Pudya, I also took an answer, or perhaps at least the beginning of the sentence or the paragraph that the answer could possibly dwell in. And I have a sweet song, vibrational movement, a dance of snuggled insecurity from within the sound hole, from within the depths of my soul, from everywhere, everything, all at once. And then to play my song to the wind, which sings in return for the epic that is life, that is love, that is only to feel the idea of what it could possibly be to house the word home. Once again, on top of the gas well, I play the harp for you, Whiskey Run, entity of which cannot really be named, idea that is so strong that word itself does no justice, a feeling like has never been felt before, exhilarating like remembering the first breath out of the womb. Rebirth, I've experienced what seems like many, but I am now discovering how it feels to be alive, and it is both so beautiful and terrifying all at the same time, more than I could ever have thought to imagine. And up in the trees, we were the breath of this place, seemingly, existing separately but of the same entity. And I've got a well full of tears of purity to offer in pale but concentrated return for all that you have shown me. Fiddles in the distance, and there are no words for true understanding, and there are only half-assed interpretations on how even to begin describing the idea of destiny. Flames go in brightly now, but I am immersed in the most beautiful shades of vulnerability. Shades like the gradation of twilight skies, shades like shadows shifting, light playing with mind. There are so many other words to describe it, you know. We can all say it, but how many feel it? You may not need say it. For it is only another word to describe how it feels to be alive. But there are really no words, not even itself, to describe it. It just is. The rawest, most beautifully terrifying intensity that is only the glimmer of a small sliver of an idea that we can only begin to try and wrap our heads around. And it is why we do it. And we do all of it for this. It is the real beauty in the bullshit. And may whatever strength I have found here save me when the fault lines crack, for I have fallen, and no time soon do I plan on leaving the ground. And as you left, I played a song of epic departure, a song of mourning, a song of glorious return. And I could sense a scent I now call home amidst the vibrations to resound all around. Autoerotic vibratory salutations, and I am perched like a songbird to harp on such melodically exposed heartstrings and these written words to be read aloud when the time is right. These two are my offerings. And upon fierce conductor, once again the gas well, I songly sang to the dawning of the migrational morning sound. Harp, fiddle, voice, peace, down through the tubes to find fear's release. We said good morning, whiskey run, and good omens to the day ahead, towards finding the essence of body, and our voices melded into such beautiful sound, only sound, the sound of none other than one entity separately coming to be one, while all collectively giving the purest form of appreciation, music. For love is sound, echoing all around to the sunrise, to the gas dewdrops of tomorrow today. It will be okay. Face your fear as you see fit. For outside, to find release means also to find struggle and trial here in this piece. And I have found a sense of home, understanding, and mutual speechless communication I never thought could exist. Just imagine now a scream of tonal purity in a clearing where to reality we are not only bound, for there are so many more feelings to be found. And today my voice makes no words, only vibrations, sweet, estranged, melodic sounds, but no estranged at all. Rather unified, the collective sound, the breath are the mother vein. And now I finally understand, awake asleep. And for such an epic as this, is now a song that echoes through the veins. I went by myself, pummeling gracelessly through the woods to find what is my own. I did it alone, and every step I took, she sang the song until I made it to her and melted into rock. And there she showed me everything that I had for so long denied myself of seeing, of understanding, and I accepted her love with no objections. And she and I, we played music of melting minds as she blossomed and flowed, and all in perfect time with all of the realizations bursting forth and rising and falling of the rhythm. This is where I found myself. This is where I came to understand my real name. This is where I came to understand my past, my present, and my purpose. And the sun came and she shined her light down on these realizations. Then I laid down, groped the earth, and shed tears for the beauty that I was finally able to see. And never did the song stop echoing its haunting melody. And adored in broccoli and rusty treasures, my eyes were wide as I felt I was being cradled by the entirety of everything, showing me all that I was up until now not fully ready to see. And as it flowed through me, I stared peacefully, basking in the beauty of everything all at once. And as I fell through the cracks of nightfall, I sang the higher, darker tones of mourning, sorrow, and appreciation for those that may never, ever know how to accept themselves to the love that they truly deserve, for all of those who I have ever known, who will come to know, and those I'll never know again. For every bridge I've ever loved, crossed, or burned, your arches are forever etched into my mind, and with my ear to the ground, I sang the song of which we will call from and for and of Dune. And there were voices under the soil echoing the melody, under the same soil where other epics have been written and will forever be remembered. But to try and tell the tale after it has happened does no justice to the experience. The only way it will ever be accurately depicted is through song, the song of For and By Whiskey Run, the song for the unification of such an epic entity. It is the song of the beautiful enthusiasm. It is the essence of everything all at once. And this is what we call, this is what we call awe. This is what we call the awe sound. And I thank you once again for giving me a place to call home, for I am finally finding how to become my own warmth. And may your song echo always, for you are the mother vein. You are the maternal eternity. Now let the whiskey run through me, for I have become part of thee. End of that one. Okay. I'm going to try to run through these fast. Okay, so this is the...
Echo turned off, please,
or turned down. Thank you.
Oh,
geez. The problem with the live feed is creating an echo. I think Jeff is trying to fix it, but it's not... If we can only remove it by stopping the live feed, then...
Okay, this is the second part of the first part, which is called the darker sound of the awe sound and delving into duality. I'm going to say some nonsense words that I might not actually be able to pronounce well, but if you've ever heard it, then you'll understand it, and maybe your brain will start turning and you'll go as crazy as I did when I wrote this. this also was written in the same place that the other one occurred, so... Yeah. This is going to be embarrassing. Pull it like a second skin. Can't spell sound. Tweller, nether, it was tether. Tweller, leather, leather, copter, quello, leather, nether, nether, not it was a coptis. Twa, copter, cup, and tomorrow, copter, language is useless here. Presence is everywhere, as is only the present moments are simply words. That word, that unspellable, unutterable word, that is only this, the sound of this. What is this? What is what I would call it if I chose to revoke all words? Words are only used to try and describe this. It is useless, yet I still continue to try. Twelelelelelelele tether tomorrow. And this is an attempt to release it. That incessant sound, sound of self, sound of language, sound of wanting to release sound, but simultaneously silencing. And I am writhing around trying to get it out, but all expressions are meaningless. Twitching and spitting and everything that isn't talking, expressing. But what is expressing when you don't know the self you are trying? Such interrupting sound. I can't tell whether my mind or my body is the prison. That is what running from yourself and finding there is nowhere to run that isn't where you just ran from looks like. And what is communication but a need to be heard or seem important? This is the bottom dropping out of the side of the surrounding beauty that everything is. Not what you heard or would like to see. This is the other side of twirlelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelel a word, then perhaps I would gain the key to being able to accept existence as just what it is and nothing more and nothing less. I am a prisoner of product, or rather, that which I feel I should be producing. Why document to legit or le, what's a who's a wahoon? Can anyone else hear this word? Why can't I just accept it? I keep trying, I'm going insane from sound. Or having let myself not produce or be it. What is product? What is music or sound if not? It is what you lay plugged up sound. What's it? Gotta get it out. That's awkward. Trying to make not what it is, not that I want from a product or song or music, but rather just to make it, to utter it. Lay, whether all words put together, it is all languages of all time put together all at once in one moment of what would one even call it? This is that, and it is gut-wrenching, but would it cease if ever not supposed to? Acknowledgement and acceptance are two different things. It is awe, but it doesn't sound like it or anything you've heard before. I can't even think my own thoughts, for I need to give them off to achieve sense of purpose, but what are those words? Why document pages as if this pen would cease its flowing, confusing convulsions of voluntary lack of willingness to do or be anything without the support or attention or direction of others? This is the side. This is the other side of the twirling. This is what no one wants to look at or acknowledge is around in the art of accepting, which is the is and seems to be the ultimate submission. This is unbearable calm on the other end of running from and in and of yourself. The only thing that quells this never-ending now word is to keep trying to describe it. But this is the side of the awe sound they didn't want you to know about, or rather, was it you who did not want to see it yourself? For there are two parts to every embrace. There are many facets to everything which we accept. I feel like the snake eating itself, or rather, that entire process. I can't handle, lay. It's a non-word, like a windmill, kind of like a helicopter, but not. It is the sound of which everything else tries to quell, but never finds. It's like I am also made up of that which you see in that is always the kaleidoscope, the sound, twiddle was a sitta, every morphing idea that isn't really a word at all, only quelled in writing, twiddle. I've also heard that sound of self if I impose it. The sound of that in and of itself is a spectacle forever folding twirly-lays. It's a twirly-lay. The sound of forever desperately chasing a means in which to express that which never ceases. I require so much attention. It's no wonder after having seen and done all of this, I would be left still with such confused longing of wishing to still be able to express. It's a wonder I can even function. There are two sides of this that I am discovering. Or rather, after having seized the interfold of sound, I wonder if it's only an illusion that there are two sides at all. There are... in... whew... and that in truth, there may only be infinite, multifaceted fish scales on an ever-morphing idea that is forever imploding and exploding in and of itself simultaneously. The illusion of two sides is only what we can perceive of the reality that for everything there is its opposite, even if we cannot necessarily find the word to contribute to it. Can a hey-le-le-le, hula-wala, cop to clay, lay. But for all parts, light and dark, there exists its dark counterpart. But they exist in and of themselves, all in between.